What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing the Renogy 100 amp hour 12 volt self-heating lithium iron phosphate battery. Let's get into it. For you guys that are new to the channel, I have developed a simple solar guide that is perfect for anyone who is a beginner or just getting started and doesn't know a ton about solar power systems. The guide goes through every component that you need to install and how to install it. It also has a list of all the components that you'll need, as well as discount codes and a very thorough schematic that will help you lay out and install your solar system with ease. That'll be linked below. Be sure to check it out. So first things first, why do you need a heated battery? And do you actually need one? If you live in a cold climate like me and Kaylee up here in Canada, we get temperatures down to like minus 30, minus 40 during the winter, but that doesn't stop us from going out and skiing and exploring the Rockies during the wintertime. We require a heated battery because it gets freaking cold. We need that battery to keep charging when it gets cold off of our alternator and our solar panels. If you don't have a heated battery, you can really damage your cells if you try to charge your lithium battery below 0 degrees Celsius. And at this temperature, that's when the heated batteries turn on, when they sense a charge coming in, so it doesn't damage the cells. And these heated batteries are actually quite smart. This feature is built into the BMS system. If for some reason it's not working, they also have low temperature cutoff. So that is just a second level of protection if you're traveling around in freezing conditions. A lot of people don't agree that you actually need a heated battery because lithium actually gives off heat when it's discharging or charging, which helps keep the battery and the cells inside warm. But this is only in places where you might get down to 0 to -5 degrees Celsius. If you plan on traveling to anywhere that gets below negative 10 degrees Celsius or colder, I would definitely recommend getting a heated battery. If you're someone who loves the outdoors in the winter, like skiing, snowboarding, snowshoeing, winter hiking, because it's better to know you have that heated battery just in case the weather turns than to not have it and be worried about it. Lithium is also so expensive these days that it's not worth the risk, and heated batteries have come down in price a lot, along with, honestly, all lithium batteries, so the extra cost is worth it. Another option, if you don't want to go with the heated battery, is to get some sort of heating pad or insulate your battery. But I've found by the time you actually do this and spend the money and time creating an insulated box or installing a heating pad, you might as well have just bought the heated battery, because usually it's only like 10% more of the battery itself. The investment is worth it, and it is going to be a lot more efficient because it doesn't have to heat that space up around the battery. The heating pads are right beside the cells, so it's much more effective. This is the battery itself. You know, Renogy, it's pretty basic on the design, nothing too fancy, but it's simple, it's compact, and it works great. Along with the manual, you're also going to get some extra terminal bolts, which come in handy. Trust me, I've lost a couple of these. You're also going to get this little switch that you plug into the top here, and this will take your battery out of shelf or storage mode. So sometimes you can get heated batteries and they're quite a bit larger, but Renogy has done a great job at keeping it small, compact, and simple. There is no strap along the top. Instead, there's built-in handles on each side for carrying. And then on top here, they have two ports, the up port and the link port, which is for communicating with either the BT2 battery monitor or communication battery to battery. I have done a review video on the BT2 monitor and would definitely recommend it. It comes in real handy. I always have mine hooked up to my DC to DC charger with MPPT controller, so I can see how much power I'm getting from the solar panels or the alternator while we're driving. To take the battery out of shelf mode and into active mode, all you have to do is plug this switch into the up port in the top and it'll start glowing. If it is a dimmer glow, it'll be in shelf mode. And to take it into active mode, all you have to do is press and hold that button and it'll light up, indicating that the battery is now in active mode. To put it back into shelf mode, if you plan to store the battery for long periods of time, all you have to do is hold the button for 3 seconds and then that'll put it back into shelf mode. If you plan on installing more than 100 amp hours, you can buy multiple of these batteries and you can buy a link cable, and that will allow the BMS in each battery to talk to each other and make sure they're balanced and working properly. One thing about the Renogy batteries is because they are made up of pouch cells, which is a little different from other batteries, It keeps them more compact, but you can't connect these batteries in series, only parallel. You can only do a 12 volt system. You can't do a 24 or 48 volt system. If this battery senses that it's starting to receive a charge and the temperature is below 41 degrees Fahrenheit, the heating feature will automatically come on using that power from the solar panel, from the charger, from the alternator, heat the battery up, and then once it gets to a certain temperature, it will start accepting that charge. Once the battery gets to 50 degrees Fahrenheit, that heating feature will automatically shut off to save power. This battery has a charge rate of up to 50 amps and a discharge rate of 100 amps. This battery comes with a 5-year warranty. Some of the safety features that's included with the BMS is self-balancing, over-discharge, overcharge, short circuit, and overcurrent protection, which gives you peace of mind and lets you not have to worry about the most expensive part of your solar system. The price between this heated battery and Renogy's normal 100 amp hour battery is only $70. So that's not very much. It's definitely a little bit more expensive than getting a heating pad and insulation, but the time that you're gonna spend doing those things is just not really worth it, in my opinion. It's much better just to go with the heated battery. You know everything's internal and working as it should. You can trust a little bit better than getting one of the cheaper heating pads off of Amazon. If you use the discount code MADETOTRAVEL when you check out, you'll also get a little extra savings, so be sure to do that. Let's see what's inside here. Got the cover off here. Renogy has done a really great job at keeping everything extremely protected. Everything is really well sealed. The connections are super strong in here. There is extra protection on here, which you don't honestly see very much. Everyone always seems to give Renogy a really hard time for their customer service, which can be a little more challenging if you live internationally. In the States, I've heard it's pretty good, but they do have an exceptional build quality compared to other batteries and chargers and inverters. Even though they might be lacking a little bit on the customer support side, they do make a very solid product. All the threaded connections have Loctite on them. What I'm searching for here is I would like to see the heating pads as well as the temperature sensors. I have the pouch cells out of the case here. They're still in this hefty metal box. I have not seen this before, but I also have the BMS disconnected here. I cannot believe how well built this battery is. I got this cover off. This is where the pouches are actually located, just inside here. And then it looks like there's insulation with tape. And then there's going to be 6 pads that go around here that are the heating pads. And then I believe there are also 2 temperature sensors somewhere in here. This is like tape shut. I don't want to go removing all of this because I could possibly damage the pouches. But I'm going to put this cover back on and get this reassembled. I'm really impressed at the build quality of this battery. It's a lot better than some of the other ones I've seen. And I think Renogy has done not only a great job with the durability of this, but also keeping it as light and compact as possible. Right now I have the Renogy 200 amp hour BT battery and it has worked awesome for me. Me and Kaylee use it during the summer months and I love how I can easily connect to it on my phone, see what's going on exactly with my solar power system, and I've never had any issues with it. Just so you guys know, Renogy did provide this battery for me to review, but I did pay for all of my Renogy products out of my own pocket that we use in our solar system now, and I'm fortunate that they're able to support this channel, and I'm really grateful. I would encourage you to go out and research all sorts of solar products because there's always new ones coming to the market and it's always worthwhile. I have had really good luck with Renogy. I would recommend them to people. I think they're really budget friendly and I think they're really reliable and I think they're a good product. Although I know they can lack in customer service sometimes. Battery is all back together and I never actually did an initial voltage test. 13.28 volts, which is what it was shipped at. Let's go and install this and I'll do a charge and a discharge test on this and see how it operates. I've gone ahead and installed the 100 amp hour battery, hooked up the positive. I have 2 aught gauge wire here. I will link below the recommendations that I have for the lugs and the wire just on Amazon. If you want to try and get a cheaper deal on the wire, because it can be pretty expensive, you can always try out your local welding store. Sometimes they have pretty good deals. Just make sure it's 100% copper for both the lugs and the wire. You don't want to go with sometimes there's aluminum or tin covered copper wire, so avoid that at all costs. First off, gonna take the battery off of shelf mode by holding that, waiting till it illuminates that bright color. Then we're going to unplug it and plug in my BT2 monitor, which is installed just right over here. After that, we can go ahead and turn on my main power switch to my battery, and then we can turn on the solar power. And then if we had multiple 100 amp hour batteries connected in parallel, you can connect up to 4 maximum. We would be connecting this port as well to the other battery. So this is honestly really nice. Top here you can see 61% total max capacity, 100 amp hours, present capacity 60, present voltage, present current. You can tell if the heating modules are on or off, the firmware version, if there's any error codes, and then maximum temperature, minimum temperature, and then cell voltage, and you can see each individual cell here broken down into 4. So right now I'm pulling in 20 amps from solar. This battery can take 50 amps. So what we're gonna do is I am going to turn on my inverter. I'm gonna adjust it to pull 50 amps and I'm gonna turn off the solar, and then we're gonna test this out and see how this charges it. So I've adjusted my inverter to pull 50 amps off of short power. I've plugged in. The present current is 51.46, so we're honestly a little bit over, but pretty close. I guess adjusting it, I should probably drop it down to 45. So maybe I'll just go in and do that right now. Down arrow to 45, hit enter, go back. See if this adjusts. I might have to reset it. Oh no, it dropped down. So now we're just pulling 46 into the battery. So that worked awesome. This inverter is honestly unreal. I love this inverter. Never had any issues with it. Very easy to manage. I've also added Bluetooth on the side here for my Renogy One. There's a little Bluetooth module so I can control it from my phone. Now that I've tested out the charging up to 50 amps, I've turned the solar back on to 20 amps, and we're gonna see how this battery does discharging at 100 amps, which is the maximum. My hot water here pulls about 125 amps, but the fact that we're getting about 20 amps from solar should be a good test for this battery. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn that on and see how it works. So we are pulling 110 amps out of this battery. Seems to be working well. We aren't getting any error codes. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. If you want to check out the Renogy 100 amp hour self-heating battery, I would recommend getting a couple of these for your system. Having 200 amp hours is perfect for me and Kaylee. Honestly, we could probably do a little bit more, but 200 amp hours is definitely enough for everything that we need to do. If you use the discount code MADETOTRAVEL, you'll get an extra savings at the end when you go to check out on the Renogy website. So be sure to do that and save a little bit of money. If you're new to solar and need a little help installing your solar system, be sure to check out the guide in the link below. If you found this video useful, make sure to like and subscribe. It really helps support the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one.